In this demo, I will show you how the Dataflow and pipeline experience can create a powerful and comprehensive data solution. Here we have the homepage of Data Factory in Fabric. Let's start by creating a data flow. Users who are familiar with Power Query will appreciate the familiarity of the low-code yet customizable experience. With over 100 connectors, you can get data from many sources. As you can see here, I have already imported my two tables, my orders table and my customers table from my worldwide importer SQL database. Along with the two tables I've brought in, I have a customer's Excel file that I have on my file system that I would like to bring in. I am just going to drag and drop the file into my editor, and immediately I am brought to the Connect to a New Data Source page, where I can see that my customer's file has been uploaded. Data Preview allows me to see my data before selecting the data to clean and transform. Now that I have brought in my data, I'm ready to transform the data at high scale. Along with altering columns and rows, I can also merge and append queries. Let me first start by merging my customers and orders query. I can specify the queries I want to merge, along with the column I want to merge on. Now, I can see a new query with all columns from the customer table and one column with the nested data from the orders table. Along with merging and appending queries, I can also transform the data using Group By. Group By allows me to group rows in my query based on the values in the selected column. For this example, I will group out the related titles for each customer. Now we can see a new transformation has been made to the query showcasing our new output. With Dataflows, you can set your output destination to store your transformed data. In this example, I will write the results to a table in a Trident data warehouse. Let's put in the server and connection credentials to my data warehouse. I will then choose a destination target and give the table a name. I will leave the default as replace, essentially meaning that any tables with the same name will be replaced in my warehouse. I will quickly rename my data flow to Contosa Data Flow, and then I can publish it. And with that, in my workspace, my data flow is complete. Now let's design our pipeline. Trident Data Integration includes the rich data orchestration capabilities that currently exist in Azure Data Factory. And with pipelines, customers can perform sophisticated data orchestration at an enterprise scale. Users who are familiar with ADF will appreciate the familiarity of the low-code yet customizable experience. Here is our existing lakehouse, Contoso Lakehouse. You can get started with building pipelines directly in the lakehouse. In this example, I will use the Copy Assistant to copy data from multiple Azure SQL data tables to the lakehouse. The Copy Assistant empowers any users to quickly get up to speed with creating pipelines that bring data to the Microsoft Cloud. Let's connect to an Azure SQL database and bring in some tables. Let's bring in 4 tables from my database. After selecting the tables, I can see a preview of it as well. Then I can choose my data destination output. I can either create a new lakehouse or use an existing lakehouse. Let me choose an existing one. Let's give my new tables names. And just like how I did in the Dataflow example, I will make sure I overwrite my tables just in case there are any duplicates in my lakehouse. I am provided with a quick summary of what I just did. And just like magic, we can enable users to copy multiple tables quickly to their favorite data destinations. The pipeline experience also includes a library of activities that will enable rich and sophisticated data orchestration. I can add a data flow activity to execute the data flow that I previously created. While Dataflow provides no-code transformation, we can also leverage notebooks for the code-centric transformations. Let's add a notebook activity, and I will select an existing notebook that I have created that stores the products in my product table by color. I will save my pipeline, And now I will run the pipeline with the notebook and the data flow. And there you go, the pipeline ran successfully. I hope you enjoyed this short walkthrough.